morning, everybody. I am in Battle Creek, Michigan. I was at a truck stop and I was stuck. I couldn't go anywhere when I tried to go somewhere this morning. But I carry a bag of kitty litter. It ain't because I got a cat. That is the best stuff you can put on underneath your tires to get going. I'm finally getting gone. I gotta deliver this load in Kalamazoo. It is cold. I have 13 below zero on my mirror, on my thermometer. That's not wind chill, that's just temperature. You want to hear what a diesel engine sounds like when it's cold? This one's cold. Deliver this load, and then we're on our way to Holland to pick up our next load. I want that load. It is going to Fort Lauderdale, Florida, and hopefully it ain't 20 degrees and snowing in Fort Lauderdale, which is just north of Miami, because if it is, there ain't no hope. I just want to get out of the frigid cold. Some of you guys can't get out of it, but I can. Was 13, 12, now it's 12, then it goes to 11, but that's minus. And it's so cold, I got steam coming out of my pipe up there, my exhaust system. That's cold. This is I-94.
Split it between both tanks.
But I have to say, I'm impressed. As I got down to 13 below, and I didn't gel. Yeah, this is kind of tricky here. I can do it as long as I don't have to hit my brakes. That's the secret, guys. When you're on ice, there's two things you don't do. One, you don't turn your steering wheel real fast. And three, don't hit your brakes. If you're on it, just go with the flow. It's white knuckle, but just stay with the flow. Don't make no sudden moves, and you won't slide off. That's always been my, well, that's what's always worked for me. I've never put a truck in the ditch or in the medium. You gotta drive with some common sense when it's winter. Well, we are empty. Now we're headed to Holland to pick up our load. That's going to Florida. And I hope it's 70 a palm tree. I hope it. And it's a little slick here in Kalamazoo. I stepped on the accelerator and my... Might as well let her talk first. But I spun wheels back there. You know, I'm really shocked that Michigan's roads aren't a little better than this. And this is winter up here. I mean, this is what they're used to, you know. But I know it's...
In 1/2 mile, TD exit 1, exit 74B, US 131 North, clear traffic.
We got 5 above. So at least it ain't in the minus. It was 0 whenever I got to my delivery back there. Now it's 5 above, so I think you guys are gonna warm up. It's
TD
damn near
exit
summer.
One, exit 74B, US 131 North, clear traffic.
She just likes to talk in there, don't she? And you're probably thinking, why don't I turn her down? Well, you know, it's kind of a strange thing to say, but it's company. It's another voice in here besides
my own. 2 miles. Keep to the left on US-131.
She doesn't say excuse me or please. She just starts talking. Well, we're going to Holland. See you guys when we get there. I am in Ostego, Michigan. I think I'm saying that right. O-T-S-E-G-O. I'm on Highway 89, cutting through the woods. I'll take this to 40, then 40 into Holland. Look at the snow, man. They got a ton of snow here. Quite a bit. Well, it's snowing. I'm over here by Holland, though. I'm over by the lake. And it's snowing. Wasn't a bad way to go. This is the way I was told to go to get to Holland from Kalamazoo, but it took an hour. That's only because of the roads. But we're getting close. Alrighty, I finally got my load. Supposed to went to Fort Lauderdale, Florida, but You know, when I was a kid, I lived in Lakeville, La Paz, in a little town called Tyner, T-Y-L-E-R, Tyner, Indiana. And if you guys are wondering where that is, it's between Walkerton and Plymouth. But I went to school here in Lakeville, and I also went to school in La Paz, but right now that's a fire department.
Warning, curve ahead.
Whoa, I just slid right there. My wheels just let loose right there. It's a little slick, just a little bit. Estes don't care, he's gonna hammer down. Anyway, I was raised here before we moved to Missouri. This is also where I lived when the 78 blizzard hit Indiana. If you guys see any cord that's on my dash, I got my new logbook in here. It's my e-log. I gotta kind of fix my cord a little bit so it looks neat on my dash. But I apologize if you see any cord on my dash. And yes, it's dark. I didn't get my load in Holland until 7:45 tonight. Now that's where I went to school, but it's a fire department now. Yep, it's a fire department now. And all this up here, the Arby's, the Burger King, the McDonald's, all this wasn't here. They had a little gas station on the corner up here, and just past that on the left hand side there was a Dog and Suds. And I remember when I was a kid, every now and then Dad say, let's go to La Paz and go to Dog and Suds and get a big root beer and a chili dog. But all this wasn't here. Now that speedway that's over there, that speedway right there, now that was there. But right down the road from there was a hardware store. And that's where Dad always went if he needed something for the house or something. He would go there. I guess the reason for me showing you guys all this, this is my stomping ground. I was just a little bitty trucking jukebox at that time. Hurt. And like I twisted my knee, but I didn't twist my knee. Indianapolis, and we are at a Pilot. It's been a long day today, but not really nothing. I mean, I started out in Battle Creek, delivered a load in Kalamazoo, went to Holland to go pick up a load, then farted around. I went straight there to pick up a load. I was supposed to go to Fort Lauderdale and ready for me to be, you know, ready for it to be picked up right now. They changed the plan a little bit. Instead of going to Fort Lauderdale, I had to go to Orlando, which is fine. But that load wasn't ready until 7 o'clock tonight. But 7 o'clock, I go check in, let them know I'm there. 45 more minutes before the load is done. So I didn't really get my load until what? 7:45. So it's 1:30 in the morning. I'm in Indianapolis. And I'm gonna get up in the morning, hammer down as much as I can, try to get as much out as I can as far as miles. That Kalamazoo load that I delivered, that was trip 5. Picked that up over in the Bronx. The load that I'm on right now, this is trip 6. And today basically the first day of trip 6. I have 16 degrees on my thermometer and I'm in Indianapolis. Well, at least it's a little warmer. I think I showed you guys on my on this video that I was 13 below zero at one point this morning. I was cold. But anyway, y'all have a good night and I'll catch you tomorrow. Y'all have a good day. Bye.